Drive, brought to you by Briggs & Stratton. Here we are, our first ever broadcast of the Briggs & Stratton Novice. Great little class. These are the Canadian Karting Championships. A great group photo, just great souvenirs for so many of the drivers to look back at when they become adults and more mature drivers from all different classes, thrown in there with some of the officials. We see some drivers in their 60s and some drivers of 7 and 8 years old. It's always quite a momentous occasion when we get the whole gang together there for this group photo at the Canadian Karting Championships. On pole position, little Mia Knickel from Nova Scotia was very dominant in qualifying and in the heat races. Ethan Donkers, don't count out little Ethan there in P2. You can just see how excited he is to be racing karts. Alec Drummond, hey, I'm here too, and I have a chance to win this race. They're just so adorable at that age. Jesse King can barely see over the steering wheel in his CRG kart. You can see him smiling through the helmet. Nick Gilks, also another one who's smiling. This guy says, hey, this car racing almost stuff is easy, man. Just give me my helmet, and yeah, okay, I'm going to take a little bit of sun before the race starts. Callum Baxter in P7. This is just a great class. So much sportsmanship at this young age. The parents are doing a great job. Xander Stevens in P8. P9, Jacob Leblanc. Look at these drivers. Just so Aiden Ingrata in P10, I believe, and in P11. Oh, full concentration there for William Lowther. This is a Briggs & Stratton. This is the first year we have this Canadian championship in the Briggs & Stratton Novice. It's basically the same engine that they use in senior and junior, but with some restrictions on it to keep the speed down, because important to note, the drivers are just so light that if we don't even put any restriction on their engine, they could probably go faster than the seniors. And the idea is not to go dangerously fast, but to go race fast. Here we go, starting up, Gerald Casely, who's the mentor. Gerald Senior and Gerald Junior have taken Mia Knickel under their wing, and have produced some pretty strong results so far this weekend. But there he is, little Ethan Donkers. You can just see in his eyes how determined he is to make a challenge for this race. Drivers revving up their engines, ready to go. I love that. Yeah, just revving up their engines, ready to go. I'm sure they go to sleep at night dreaming of one day being a Formula One driver or a NASCAR driver. Look at in-cart footage here from, I'll presume that's Maya's kart, and it gives you an idea of the speed that these young drivers have to manipulate. Like I said, it's not dangerously fast, but it's racing fast. Going down that long straightaway at Mont-Tremblant as they go into the hairpin, which is known as corner three, where a lot of the action and a lot of the passing has taken place throughout this weekend here at the Canadian Karting Championships here at Circuit de Karting Mont-Tremblant, house of the Académie Jim Russell. You can see the ski hill there in the background. One of the most beautiful, beautiful karting tracks. We're so lucky in Canada in these last couple of years to have so many great karting tracks being built up. We have Mosport, we have Mont-Tremblant, just fabulous facilities. Here we go as the drivers line themselves up here for this final, who will be the first ever Canadian karting champion in the Briggs & Stratton Novice? We will find out in about 15 laps. Look at the young drivers, very professional. They take this very seriously. They're very content on listening to the officials, following the instructions. This is the last corner, I believe. It's a little uphill shoot. Left-hander corner 15 as they go to the start-finish line. That looks a bit fast to me, but no, the start is given. Here we go. It started, the first ever Briggs & Stratton Novice Canadian Karting Championship race, as Mia Knickel holds on to the lead with Ian Donker. Donker's right behind him. Oh, Ian had a very good run coming out of corner two. Will he be able to challenge going into the hairpin? Yes, he is. Here comes Ian Donkers, and getting a little help too from Alex Drummond. There you go, Mia Knickel, who dominated all weekend, is now in third place. Ian Donkers, we can see it on the starting grid. He just looked so determined and wanted to be the first ever Canadian champion in the Briggs & Stratton Novice. It's a great concept, this class. Very affordable for young drivers and their parents to give themselves a taste of what racing is all about. There we see that was Gilkes in fourth place now starting to challenge Maya Kanikel, who had her own way throughout the weekend. But now it's not about Maya Kanikel. It's Ethan Dockers. Look at him fighting with that steering wheel. As he gets older, he'll try and be a little bit smoother with the steering wheel. But for the time being, your leader, one lap in the books, Ethan Dockers, followed very closely by Alex Drummond. And we have a battle now for third place between Gilkes and Kanikel. Kanikel in the Ricardo cart. Actually, they're both Ricardo carts. So we have our Ricardo kart drivers in third and fourth place. Just fabulous. Look at the speed as they come into the hairpin. A little different strategy taken by the by Gilkes, the driver in fourth place, as he went a bit wider going into the hairpin. Well, you'll notice too as you follow the race closely, it's maybe not quite as precise as you'll get in the senior class. Oh, there goes Maya Kanikel on the inside of Drummond. Can she make it work? Yes, she did. Here comes Drummond back on Maya Kanikel. A battle, ferocious battle for second place. Easy come, easy go. Kanikel into second. Drummond back into second. Now Kanikel back into second place. Maya Kanikel, who dominated earlier, is now having to work her way up to see if she can make it back to the front. But that Ethan Dockers looks so determined. Will he hang on and win the first ever Canadian Karting Championship in Briggs & Stratton Otis, in Briggs & Stratton Novice? This commentator's a little excited looking at these little guys battling it out. You can just see how intense they are. Hunched over the steering wheel, going down that long straightaway. And this is where we've seen the passing all weekend. This is corner three, the hairpin corner at the end of the long straightaway. You can sometimes get away with an outside line. And sometimes you don't. It's very, very tricky corner. I love driving this track because it's there's in some of the corners you can take different lines and it works out. Meanwhile, a battle here for third place as we got Gilkes trying to take that last position, that last podium position away from our third place driver. There we go. Ethan Dockers being attacked by Maya Kanikel. Alex Drummond was in third place, and he's trying to hang on to that place, but now we got two battles going on. We have one going for the front. Ethan Dockers being challenged by Kanikel, and there's Alex Drummond in third place being challenged by Gilkes. Will Gilkes be able to get by Alex Drummond for the final podium finish? Oh, Maya Kanikel had a very good run coming out of corner two. That's where a lot of these races are decided, how clean you are coming out of corner two. Maya Kanikel on the end. Inside with some hard braking. Now they are side by side going into four. Dockers is gonna come back here on the inside of corner five. Ethan Dockers now back in the lead. Tremendous battling here from our novice drivers. Dockers is leading as he retook the lead in corner five. He went outside four, inside five. Dockers your leader, Kanikel is in second, and this has allowed our third and fourth place competitors. Alex Drummond is now back on the bumper of Maya Kanikel. And that's Nick Gilkes, I believe, in fourth place. So we have Alex Drummond in third, Nick Gilkes. Oh, very late braking there by Alex Drummond. We got our top four drivers all battling together. Here comes Maya Kanikel on the inside of corner one. Not an ideal place to pass. No, I didn't think so. Oh, a little bump there as Alex Drummond was flying through corner two, and Maya had to lift off the throttle having tried to pass on the inside there, or corner one. I mean, that's not really the best place to pass. It can be made. Now here comes Alex Drummond. Is he going to challenge for second place? No, not quite. Meanwhile, here we go. Ethan Dockers, Maya Kanikel, Alex Drummond, and Nick Gilkes. One, two, three, and four. Your top four competitors in this Briggs & Stratton Novice. This is turning out to a real interesting race right now. Ethan Dockers just looks so determined in his Tony car with the black helmet. You can see him on the starting grid, how determined he was. He wants to be the first Canadian karting champion in Briggs Novice. And there we go, Alex Drummond and Neil Gilkes. They're not too far in third and fourth. Not only are they battling it out for the last podium position, but they're telling themselves, you know, maybe we can get to the front and win this thing. Oh, we see Maya Kanikel go wide. Yeah, that's not going to allow her to attack here going into corner one. Oh, there he goes. Nick Gilkes is on the outside of Alex Drummond. Who's going to make it? No, Alex Drummond hangs on to third, and He pats the back of his helmet as if to take notes. No, don't pass me. Let's bump draft me. Let's go to the front. Meanwhile, inside card coverage here of Maya Kanikla as she dives on the inside of Ethan Donkers here. Ethan Donkers tries again on the outside. And here, this is where in corner five, he was able to retake the lead. But Maya, very smart driving. She drove fast, but a little bit defensive to hold on to the lead. I'll presume those are the parents very excited. Maya Kanikla, your leader. Ethan Donkers in second. Oh, Ethan Donkers up in two wheels. You just saw how hard he attacked that curb. He wants to take the lead back, but that may cost him. Meanwhile, another pass here as Nick Giltz is up into third place in the Ricardo card as he got by Alex Drummond. This is some ferocious battling from these young future drivers. We'll be back in a few seconds with the final outcome of the novice final. Here we are at the conclusion of the Canadian Karting Championship in Briggs Novice. Kanikla now has taken the lead. She's pulled away from Donkers, and Donkers has pulled away from this battle for third place between Nick Giltz and Alex Drummond. Alex Drummond keeps bumping Nick in an attempt to maybe, I don't know, unstabilize him. Oh, he had a really good run there coming out of corner two where that's really the most important corner, in my opinion, on this track. Now he dives on the inside. Can he make it work? Can he make it work under braking? Yes, Alex Drummond is now taking back that third place that he held for so long earlier in the race. But Nick Giltz looks very determined. This is a ferocious battle. I'm not overstating the fact. This is a ferocious battle for the last podium position here in the Canadian Karting Championships of the Briggs and Stratton Novice Final. Oh, there he goes back on the inside, Nick Giltz. That was a very aggressive pass. You don't often see too much passing going into that corner. But Nick being so young says, hey, I'll pass where I want, where I can. Very aggressive entry into the corners as Alex Drummond takes maybe a little bit more conservative line, trying to have better speed coming out of the corner. This battle is far from over. Let's not forget our leader, Maya Kanikla. Ethan Donkers in second place. And here he comes. Here comes Alex Drummond. This is going to be the last corner before that long straightaway. So important to get it right. Use a little bit of drafting. Here comes Alex Drummond on the inside. Alex Drummond on the inside. Yeah, he wants that third place back. But don't count out little Nick Giltz. Giltz has been very determined to finish third. He's going to try and attempt a pass. We saw him, I believe it was try to pass going into corner eight, which is not a place you see too much passing this weekend. But don't tell that to Nick. He decided, I'm going to pass where I want. Meanwhile, let's not forget our leader, Maya Kanikla, in first place, is showing the form that she showed in qualifying and in the qualifying heats. And Ethan Donkers, when he made a mistake when he dropped into second place, lost touch with Maya. And now without the draft, it's going to be very hard for him to reel her in. Last lap to go. Will we have our first ever Canadian champion in the Briggs and Stratton Novice class? Your leader, Maya Kanikla from Nova Scotia here at Mont Tremblant, trying to be the first ever novice champion. Ethan Donkers, who was just so valiant and tried so hard in the early going, led for a good part of the race. And let's not forget our battle for third place. Who will end up with the last step of the podium? Alex Drummond driving very defensive. Will that cost him? Yeah, there goes Nick Giltz around the outside. Outside of corner four doesn't work, but don't tell this to our two young drivers. Ah, yes, Alex Drummond manages to get back on corner five and six, but still driving a little bit defensive as he's going to try to prevent Giltz from getting by and getting that top podium finish. There's Ethan Donkers in second place. A valiant effort from Ethan. And there, Alex Drummond is still managing. Oh, Nick Giltz almost put his nose on the inside. Just a couple of corners left here in our final position as they side by side going into corner 14. Maya Kanikla, your winner, new Canadian Karting Champion. Oh, there goes Nick Giltz on the inside at corner 15. Couldn't quite make it work. In third place, Alex Drummond. So that's Ethan Donkers in second, Alex Drummond in third. That was just fabulous racing. So young. That must be the parents. It's the only thing I can think of. Yes, they are. Smiling like that, they must be the parents of Maya Knickel. Very excited and happy of their young daughter, first ever champion in the Briggs and Stratton novice class. I love this class. It's quite a lot of speed on a very, very affordable package. If you want to get into karting with your young kids, strongly recommended there. Once again, the new Canadian champion in Briggs and Stratton novice, Maya Knickel from Nova Scotia. Second very valiant effort from Ethan Donker. And we saw Alex Drummond edge out Nick Gilt for the final podium position there in third place. Fabulous, fabulous racing. So honorable mention to Braden Lindgren, Callum Baxter in sixth, Jesse King in seventh place. There she is, your winner in Canadian, getting the congratulations from our chief starter, gets the first parade lap of a novice champion at Mont Tremblant. We have the ASN karting insignia on the inside of that checkered flag. I wonder if the flag pulls or not for Maya, but I'm sure she doesn't mind. This is a very exciting time for her, I'm sure, being the first ever Canadian karting championship. Such a young age. And we saw a tremendous amount of determination from the drivers in this class. You can see the odd little driving errors and mistake, and that's what's great about this class of racing. It's a chance to ply your trade, to improve yourself. And we saw some mistakes you don't normally see in some of the senior class. Completely normal, of course, because they're just so young, and this is the apprentice part of racing. Is the drivers, they're getting in line just like the grown-ups. They got to get on that scale at the end of the race and go through technical inspection to make sure that mom and dad aren't doing anything they shouldn't, and keeping the carts all even and fair for everybody. And there she is, your winner, Maya Knickel. You can see her smiling through the helmet, I'm sure. But I bet you her parents are probably smiling a lot more than her. Just the parents just getting their kids into racing at this time. It's a very exciting family sport. You don't often think of racing as a family sport at this level in the Briggs and Stratton novice. It definitely is. It is a family sport, and it's affordable. There she is, your winner, Maya Knickel. Canadian karting champion Maya Knickel, first ever woman to win a Briggs and Stratton championship. Very exciting time for her indeed, and the whole family. A replay here of her pass as she dove on the inside, a corner three. This is at the end of the long straightaway. There she is, taking the lead, Maya Knickel.
So you're a Canadian karting champion. How old are you right now?
Right now I'm 11.
And do you really like karting, or do you, because your parents force you to do it?
I love karting.
Oh, you don't like karting. You love karting.
Yeah.
And is there anyone you want to thank for being Canadian champion? There was a lot of people, I guess, that helped you. And who do you want to thank about being Canadian karting champion right now?
Okay, I want to thank Gerald Casely Sr., who has worked on my kart ever since the beginning, and Gerald Casely Jr., who's been my coach. I also want to thank my parents, Janice Knickel and Roger Knickel, and all my friends and people I've raced against.
Wow, that's fantastic. And do you have any advice for someone that maybe wants to get into the sport?
My advice is to always try, never give up, and just go as fast as you can.
Thank you so much, Maya. Words of advice for racing and life in general. And you plan on being a karting a long time? Okay, thank you very much. Congratulations, your winner.
And
road pass, Michael Myers. You got a true champion, Maya Knickel.
Here we go, our beautiful trophies that are going to be handed out here at these Canadian Karting Championships. Award ceremonies coming up in just a few moments. And Briggs and Stratton generators for all our winners on the podium today. Podium celebrations, there he is, Alec Drummond, a ferocious battle. right until that final lap with Nick Gilks. Poor Nick. Like to see all the drivers at this age come home with a trophy, being such good sports. But, well, you know, it's a taste of reality. Ethan Donkers, who led in the early going, getting his trophy from one of the sponsors of this class, Lonnie Herter. We see David Klaus there of Briggs & Stratton, just so implicated in this whole project of Briggs & Stratton. There he is, Ethan Donkers. You're allowed to smile. Look at that, shaking hands. Oh, he's a little upset. He really wanted to win that race. Gave it a ferocious battle in the first early going of the race. But no, unfortunately for Ethan, could not quite get the top podium. But here she is, our winner, first ever female to be on the podium in a Briggs & Stratton Canadian Karting Championship. Big smile on her face, Maya Knickel. Holy smoky, look at the size of that trophy. And I have a feeling this will not be the first trophy for your winner, Maya Knickel. Neither Ethan Donkers or Alex Drummond, as they begin their journey into the world of the Briggs & Stratton kart racing family. Exciting times. This whole Briggs & Stratton project has brought family back into the word. Family is now part of kart racing like it was many years ago. Look at that smile. Isn't that a million-dollar smile? And there's her coach and mentor, if you like, Gerald Casely. Hopefully next year we'll have even more drivers at the Briggs & Stratton Novice class. This has been fabulous championship. We're going to have another full season of great karting racing in Canada and the U.S. Thank you so much. See you next year. I'm Norm Trottier. Champ Kart has been brought to you by Briggs & Stratton and the phenomenal kart racing engine. All my bones are